On the final night of ice dancing, Pasha Grishuk and Evgeni Platov have their sights set on Olympic history, a second gold medal never done in dance. While Russian rivals Anjelika Krylova and Oleg Ovsyannikov hope that the judging is not a done deal and that they can pull an upset, the French team of Marina, Anissina and Gwendal Peizerat is a virtual lock for the bronze, while Shae-Lynn, Bourne and Victor Kraatz, the pre-Olympic favorites to medal, will have to skate through the bitter disappointment of these Olympics. We'll see the top four teams later tonight. Among those coming up soon, the five-time American champions, Elizabeth Punsalan and Jerod. They thought they had a good chance for a top-five finish, and then came the first compulsory dance, which they skated well, but were marked down to seventh place, where they have remained and will probably finish. Good evening once again, everybody. I'm Verne Lundquist, along with Tracy Wilson and Scott Hamilton. Welcome back to White Ring, the ice dance gold medal at stake tonight. This panel of nine judges, however, has been as much a part of the story of what has taken place here as the actual competition on the ice. And Tracy, we've heard so much here about block judging.
That's right. Block judging is when judges get together to help each other's skaters. I'll help your skater, you help my skater. It only takes five judges to control the panel, and that is what has happened here. Because of the composition of the judges on this panel, the countries that they represent, we could determine basically what the outcome was going to be, and that played out in the first compulsory dance. A couple that's really suffering because of this is Elizabeth Punsalan and Jerod of the United States. They don't have a judge on the panel, so nobody's helping them. They're sitting in seventh place, but they have a great free dance, and if they can skate it well tonight, it is definitely a top five free dance. I will be very surprised, though, if they finish anywhere other than seventh. Scott, that's ice dance, but it's a little bit different in the other three disciplines.
Well, there's so much risk in single skating and pair skating that you really can't predict the outcome. Anything can happen. The ISU Dance Committee is a very strong committee. They control their own destiny, and they're really hard to control. This does not exist in singles and pair skating. But getting back to the ice dance, these skaters work so hard. They put so much of themselves into these performances, and they put their fate in these judges' hands. They expect and deserve a lot better than this.
On this panel of nine judges, a group of five comprised the block of judges to whom we refer.
It was the first compulsory dance that really set the placement for everybody. Here's a look at the Czech judge, the Russian judge, the Italian judge, the French judge. And here's the judge from Ukraine. And it was those five that appeared to be working together, set the tone for the entire competition.
On the ice now, from Italy in sixth place, Barbara Fusar-Poli and Maurizio Margaglio. Music composed by Nino Rota from the Fellini film Amarcord.
Of two programs I saw in Lillehammer, Maya Usufa and Alexander Zulin, and also Rockamo and Coco.
They were the pair from Finland. They still are the team from Finland.
Thank you. expression is it's lovely in this program. Encourages you to look at their face, their arms, their upper body. What I find with this couple is often she does the difficult work and he does a lot of work on 2 feet and supporting her. It lacks the balance that I think is necessary.
The topic of the judging panel. A group of 10 nominated to judge at the Olympic Games, and then 9 chosen by draw from that group of 10. The one who was not chosen, he is the substitute judge, is the American, Robert Horn. The Italian judge is on the panel.
Of ice dancing.
So much is done with facial expressions, and sometimes you'll see the whole program, the face is lit up, it's smiling, it's laughing, and the second they go into their bow, everything changes.
In 6th place after the original dance, their free skate now complete. From Milan and Marlborough, Massachusetts, where they are coached by Tatiana Sarasova, Barbara Fusar-Poli, and Maurizio Margaglio.
I found that program very entertaining. I thought they performed it beautifully, but watch here, watch what he's doing. A Mohawk there. Now he will stand and support her. She does a lot of the work in the program. So technically, if you really, you take yourself away from the performance and look down at their feet, I found that there was not a lot of technical difficulty. Great expression though. They sold it beautifully.
Kati Winkler doing the program with him. Katarina Witt used to do that. She used to skate to everybody's music and perform to everybody else's music. I think it's a German thing.
Mamma, papà e nonni, Silvia, Andrea.
Milan, tutti. Now the marks for Fusar-Poli and Margaglio.
Ciao.
Those are very high technical marks. Yes. And I expect that the performance level will go up because they did perform it so well. And they go up quite a bit.
An unforgettable look at this woman, Pasha, when we return. The four-time world champion, the reigning Olympic gold medalist, and the favorite to win again. But Pasha Grishuk has far more than ice on her mind. Mark Phillips has more.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, Mr. President. Happy birthday to you.
You are entering the world of Pasha, the skater formerly known as Oksana Grishuk, a world where cameras, mirrors, and the performance, especially the performance, reign supreme.
Let's do one more time.
Some athletes change countries, others change partners, but 4 months ago, Oksana decided she wanted to change her name, her identity.
No, she said to me, I want to change the name, but I felt like it's a joke. She said to me, I will be Pasha. I said, okay, maybe better Glasha. I make a joke, but I never realized it's serious like that.
I've been on TV every year for so many competitions, winning worlds, Europeans, Olympics, on the top, on the first place. And people doesn't know who I am. Plus, they think I'm somebody else.
She does.
That somebody else was the other Oksana, a fellow Russian-speaking figure skating Lillehammer gold medalist Oksana Baiul, although Pasha refuses to say her full name.
People was mistaken me with other Oksana, who first of all became very popular and then became criminal. So I didn't want people think I'm her.
Criminal might be a little harsh, although Oksana Baiul was arrested for drunk driving last winter. The relationship between Pasha and Baiul has been sometimes hostile, always bizarre. Some have even noticed a disturbing pattern. Here is the Baiul laugh 3 years ago. Here is the Grishuk laugh today. Listen to the music for the Baiul free program 2 years ago. Here's Grishuk and Platov's music 1 year later. Finally, there are the hairstyles. Guess whose came first? People magazine called it a tale of two Oksanas.
She's just a little girl on this level. Yes, she is Olympic gold medalist. Yes, she is very talented and beautiful skater. She is. But I have no reason to look at this level. Otherwise, I'll go down. I always look up.
In fact, Pasha, let's just call her Pasha, is looking up even more than that. She set her sights on imitating not just another figure skater, but the most glamorous blonde in history.
A kiss on the hand may be quite continental, but diamonds are a girl's best friend. A kiss may be grand, but it won't pay the rental on your humble flat or help you at the automat.
Her innocent and her romantic and her sexuality. I mean, she really reminds me of myself.
Hollywood has noticed Pasha's innocence, her romance, and her sexuality, trying to cast her in a movie as a Russian mafia mistress. Pasha uses the same agency that serves Julia Roberts, and she's busy reading movie scripts preparing for her next career.
What can I say? Stop your moving career and let's go just skating. If she's successful, if she's second Sharon Stone, I don't think I can keep her in my team. So I will find something else too. It's a life.
As for Pasha's life, when the all-important performance is over, she now knows what she wants her public to say.
Hello, Pasha. Can we have your autograph? It makes me really feel good. I mean, this is really... I know it's my name. I know they call me. I know they mean that it's me.
So goodbye, Oksana Grishuk. Hello, Pasha, who finally has a name to match her identity. Or does she?
Well, she may not be the girl you want to bring home to meet Mom, but she is a pretty good skater. We'll see her later tonight. Among those in the stands tonight, the bronze medalist in the pairs event, Mandy Wurzel and Ingo Steuer. They have gathered to cheer on their teammates from Germany, Kati Winkler, René Lohse, in 10th place entering the free dance. Music by Sergei Prokofiev. This is Romeo and Juliet.
Thank you.
between pairs and dances, the way in which they use their music. Generally, pair skaters skate to the melody, where ice dancers are required to skate to the rhythm. A program like this, though, really encourages you to use the melody instead of the rhythm. It's very difficult to keep it looking like an ice dance routine.
Skating. The best skaters in the world feel like they're coming from the ice. The ones that struggle are the ones that look like they're skating above the ice.
Of the German army. Think Goldie Hawn and Private Benjamin.
What's interesting also that before the wall came down, they were from East Germany. There was no such thing as ice dance, so they learned to do it from a rule book and had to go to a pairs coach to teach them and try and help them. Got a great coach now in Martin Scott Nicky, former coach of the Duchesnes of France.
They've skated together now for 9 years, this their first Olympic Games. And I think they would be thrilled with a top 10 finish. Kati Winkler and René Lohse.
Here's a look at one of the lifts in their program. I see that this couple has a really bright future. I think technically they're a little bit weak right now, but I think Martin Scott Nicky is a great technician. And I just think they were a great surprise at this competition. There's their coach, Martin Scott Nicky. And he does every move with his couples. Bangs the board, cheers them on. I expect them to keep moving up in the standings. I like this couple.
And the team from Oberstdorf, Germany, awaits the marks. Here they are for Winkler and Lohse.
Technically, they were a little weak. They were slowing down in and out of their tricks. And to keep their flow going, work on the technique, they'll be on their way up the standings.
Hi, Kati Winkler and René Lohse, quite pleased with that. Currently in fourth. When we return, the American champions on the ice. Five times the United States champions, this their second Olympic Games. It will be their final. In seventh place, entering the free dance, the husband and wife team of Elizabeth Punsalan and Jerod Swallow. Music of Astor Piazzolla.
this program and competition. Liz said sometimes it's tough to turn her brain off just to allow herself to perform. So far, skating it very well.
Why the decision, Tracy, to debut the program at the Olympic Games?
They weren't happy with their free dance this year. They didn't have time earlier in the season because of all the competitions. And it wasn't ready in time for the national championships. We started it in December, trained from 12 to 3 in the morning on the choreography.
Just watching them over the years, their biggest improvement happened the day they got married. Since then, they've been skating more as one.
That date, September 4th,
of the leg wrap there. Brings authenticity to the dance. They did it!
That's terrific. Her mom, Teresa Punsalan, on the left, and the Swallows, John and Gay.
That was a mature, sophisticated program. I thought the choreography was very interesting and very balanced. Lots of edges, some footwork.
Here come the coaches, Liz Coates, Igor Spielband. And now Punsalan and Swallow can get ready for Worlds.
I liked the way their lifts kept changing and growing. And they kept the tango expression throughout the lifts. Yes. This footwork I thought was very effective. It's difficult, it's interesting. The leg wrap shows the expression of the music through their feet. Often we just see it through the face.
And now the marks for Liz Punsalan and Jerod Swallow.
They're close to the Italians, technically.
Great, thanks.
Second set of marks.
Not enough, and you can see the way they're weighted on the panel.
They're the Ordinals. Ukraine, Germany, Czech Republic, Russia, Italy, and France rank them second. The current standings have the Italians on top, followed by Punsalan and Swallow. Lithuanian team is third, then the team from Ukraine and the Germans, Winkler and Lohse. Yet to come tonight, the top four, and they will skate in this order. Right now, let's go to the hardest working lady in Nagano. Here's Andrea Joyce with Punsalan and Swallow.
Nicely done, guys. Congratulations. Regardless of how the judging turns out tonight, what do you think? Was it a top five performance?
Well, it was a challenge for us being in New Free Dance to put it out for the first time. So we were really pleased with how we were able to skate it tonight.
We've watched you guys improve dramatically over the years. What does it mean to you to be able to go out there with a brand new program, so difficult, and perform it that way?
Well, it's definitely a confidence builder. I think Liz and I have worked hard up till the Olympics on this new program, and doing it as well as we did will give us a lot of confidence going into the World Championships, where we're really looking to gain some ground.
Well, you should be proud. It was a great job.
Thanks.
Thank you.
Later tonight, Pasha.
Hello, my friend.
And we'll return to White Ring for more Ice Dance shortly, the on-ice passion of Pasha.
Tonight we decide the third gold medal of the figure skating competition, ice dance, the free skate, and the final teams are on the ice. The current standings have two Russians in first and second place, two Russian teams. Grishuk and Platov, the defending Olympic and world champions, are first. Krylova, Ovsyannikov are second. The French team of Anissina and Peizerat third, and the Canadians, Bourne and Kraatz, are fourth. And a tough position for the Canadians. We'll show you why. It's almost impossible for them to climb on the podium. Ice dance judgments once made tend not to change. Take a look, for example, at Grishuk and Platov, first across the board. Krylova and Ovsyannikov second. They can win gold if they win the free skate, because this is worth 50% of the total score. The problem for Bourne and Kraatz is that fifth place placement after the first compulsory dance. In order to win third, they must defeat two teams. And here's one of them currently in third place, the champions of France, Marina Anissina and Gwendal Peizerat. They will interpret the roles of Romeo and Juliet, the music of Sergei Prokofiev.
They have not looked entirely comfortable throughout the first three portions of this competition. They have been skating a little tight. They are going to need to skate free tonight to really sell this program. It's very powerful and dramatic.
Thank you.
program are spectacular. They tell the story of the music, of the dance, very creative and original.
Anissina and Gwendal Peizerat from France in third place. Anissina, born and raised in Moscow, she moved to France in March of 1993 when teamed with Peizerat. Her mother was a pair skater who competed for Russia the last time the Olympics were held in Japan in Sapporo in 1972.
I like the way they perform that program, and I thought the balance was equal. He took his moment in the spotlight as well as she did. What I didn't like about this program as a competitive routine is the fact that it took them 40 seconds at the top of the program before they actually started to skate. Here's a look at some of their lifts. This time done by her. She does it twice in the program. And I really liked the way these lifts added to the expression of the program. I thought they got a little bit shaky at the end of their program. They started to tighten up. The toe picks started to dig in. Unison was a little off at the very end of the program.
And now the marks for Marina Anissina, Gwendal Peizerat.
Highest marks we've seen tonight, and that was expected.
And now the second set of marks. Anissina and Peizerat, that puts them in first. When she was looking for a new partner in 1993, she sent out letters. One went to Gwendal Peizerat. He answered his.
Merci, gentil.
The other went to Victor Kraatz. He chose not to respond. He already had a partner, and he'll skate with her next. Welcome back to White Ring. In fourth place, entering the free dance, twice world bronze medalists from Canada, Shae-Lynn Bourne and Victor Kraatz. The music, River Dance. Skipper, Shae-Lynn's mom on the left, Dagmar Kraatz, joins her.
Well, they skated that as well as I've seen them perform it. I love the energy. It was joyful. It was fresh. Really got the audience involved in their program and in their music.
Shae-Lynn's boyfriend, Stephen Cousins, looks on with some emotion.
They could have taken the low road. When told that they had no chance for a medal before the competition even began, they could have taken the low road, but they decided, no, we're going to show everybody in the world just how great we are. And they did that.
Thank you.
That is their coach, Natalia Dubovic.
Hi, Chris, Kelly, and Sean.
Top of the program. Started right away. A very busy program, a lot of footwork. It really played to the rules in the rule book.
Thanks for all the support in Canada, United States, and worldwide.
Lots of intricate footwork. They skated to the rhythm of the music.
Now the first set of marks for Bourne and Kraatz.
Criticism of this program has been that sometimes their unison is off, but that 5-5, totally out of line.
Second set, these for presentation.
That was a fine program. They should be proud.
And by a 5-4 vote, Bourne and Kraatz defeat Anissina and Peizerat in the free skate. But as we pointed out, that's not enough to put them in front of them overall. On the ice now, in quest of a little piece of history, to win their second Olympic gold medal, Pasha Grishuk, Evgeni Platov. The music composed by Michael Nyman is called Memorial Requiem.
Is this the best dance team in the world?
Technically, they're excellent. I can't question their speed, the use of the running edge. I don't think they have shown up here polished. I've seen their unison better. I believe they are beatable.
Somewhat similar reaction shown by coach Tatiana Tarasova and athlete Pasha Grishuk.
I think she got so involved in the end of the program. I've seen them do a lift at the end of the program in practice, and they chose not to do it at the end of the program. Who worked harder? They have a lot of fine qualities, a very fluid team. They never look awkward. One technique that Russian choreographers use is they repeat a move three times. So the first time the audience sees it, the second time they admire it, and then the third time they get to applaud. The end of the program usually has a lift. It looked like they got out of position a little ragged at the end of the program and chose instead just to end in a knee slide.
Opera has its three tenors. Ice dance has its three divas. You have met Natalia Dubova. Here's Tatiana Tarasova. The third is Natalia Linenchuk. Her team skates next. And the first set of marks for Grishuk and Platov.
Most important thing to Tatiana Tarasova is the emotion that her skaters deliver. I think it suffered technically a little bit because of the way they performed it.
And the second set of marks. Whoa, Italy and France. Nine judges place them first.
On the ice, representing Russia, Anjelika, Krylova, and Oleg, Ovsyannikov.
We're back at White Ring. Free dance, the gold medal to be decided tonight. In second place, entering the free dance from Russia, Anjelika Krylova, Oleg Ovsyannikov. If they win the free dance, they win the gold. The music might be say Carmen.
So much of Artur Dmitriev, the gold medalist in the pair skating event, because he skates with complete reckless abandon.
Mm-hmm. silver medalist in each of the last two world championships. In second place, entering the free skate, Anjelika Krylova, who stays in character for just a second more. And her partner, Oleg Ovsyannikov.
I thought that was the best I've ever seen them skate that program. I saw it at Europeans and the expression was too much and it lacked sincerity. But tonight I thought the expression filled the arena. It was right for them in this program. I really liked the first piece of this program the best. I thought there was a lot of content and emotion, a terrific combination of both. When the music changed, however, I felt that the acting took over at the expense of their skating. She feels it with every fiber of her being. And it works. Close-ups on TV, it's over the top. But when you're sitting in the audience, she reaches the people at the top row.
Even during practice.
Well executed, a polished performance.
Well, we await the marks from the nine judges. Was that a winning performance?
For me, it was a winning performance. I think with both programs, Grishuk and Platov's and theirs, there were criticisms with the choreography and the design of the program. But I thought they skated what they did the best. It was clean, it was polished. Where Grishuk and Platov, they had a few errors, tight moments, and they left out a lift at the end of the program.
Panel of nine. Somewhat indecisive. And now the marks.
Technical merit, 5-7, 5-8.
Technical merit in the 5-7-5-8 range.
And the problems there will come from the stop in the program, 15 seconds in the middle of the program.
Remember the two 6.0s? They know second place for Krylova and Ovsyannikov. And Grishuk and Platov become the first in ice dance to win two gold medals.
The 18th Olympic Winter Games on CBS.
They repeat as gold medalists. They won in 94, they win again tonight. And they are with Andrea Joyce. Here are Grishuk and Platov.
Congratulations. No one had ever won two Olympic gold medals in ice dancing. Evgeni, what does it mean to you to go into the history books this way?
It's everything. It's mean really everything. I can't explain it right now, my feeling, but this is great. You know, when we won the first medal, it was, you know, different feeling. Now it's, you know, something big happened.
Well, Pasha, you were so emotional when you found out that you had won. What was going through your mind? You're still emotional.